going to do some watercolor, so you know the process I do to paint, and we'll start at the from basic, really basic, okay. And so what do I have here? We have brushes, we have paint, we have paper. That's all you need. That's all you need. But there's so many choices of paint, as you can see. And then so many ways to contain it. So I have a palette, and then I put paint in it. Okay. If you think it's gonna be tough to remember what the colors are, then you give yourself a código. Okay, so no, not rocket science. There are other ways to paint, and you can buy things like this. This come all empty, and then you just put the paint in. Okay. And then this is my latest gift. This is a gift. This I buy. This is a gift. Okay.
Ta-da.
Okay. Maybe we can try it later on. Okay. All right. But you buy this only, like you can buy a whole set, but you can also buy just one at a time. All right. Wag naman one at a time. Three at a time. Okay. Because you need at least three of the colors. So these are the things that you probably would be interested in, and you can take a look at this later. Now, how to get started is usually the most important thing. Okay. What colors to use? You see, you have so many colors, but believe me, in one painting, you don't get to use all at all. Okay. What you just have to remember is you need three of the primaries. What are the primary colors? Red, yellow, and blue. That's all you need. And then to start with. And then to add to that, you need some secondary colors. But you can mix the secondary colors. Okay? Red, yellow, and blue. You mix any of the two and you get a secondary color. Like you get green, violet, and orange. Okay? What I also find very useful is to add brown. Burnt sienna. Okay? So burnt sienna is very important because it does magical things with all the other colors. So if you're going to buy anything, just that. Nothing else. And of course, you have to have a brush, you have to have paper, and you have to have a brush. You need a flat brush, and you will see how I get to do, how I get to use them later. And then maybe a variety of any. It turns out I brought these brushes because although I have a lot of brushes.
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 Yes. So, okay. That, when you have your paints, your brushes, and your paper, all you need tissue. Okay. I was panicking because I didn't have my tissue. And then you have at least two containers of water, one for washing your brush and one for clean water. And then that's it. Well, a spray bottle. That's it. People think that watercolor is very complicated, but it's not. Like I said, you just need the basic colors. And you can use any brush that you have. Okay, and then you can start it. So we'll just use some very simple subject just for you to see how it works. Now, one of the things I discovered recently, which I never used to do, well, not recently, but not what I used to do when I was starting out, is always wet your paper. Draw more what I'm going to do. So what did you say I was going to do? So I was just choosing some simple subjects for us before we get. So we're going to do at least two things today. We're going to do still life, and then we're going to do maybe a landscape with skies or whatever. So if we draw, so you know this when we're drawing for watercolor, just draw more or less just the composition of the placement of the things that you want to paint. So I draw the surface. After that, that's when I would work it. I often wondered why this was important. I never used to do this. But then watching some masters do it and watching some people that I met, and I was wondering why. And it turns out after doing it a few times, what the water does is it makes the paint more uniformly hospitable to paint. So I noticed that in the past when I painted directly on dry paper, what happens is that drying paint, it's so hard edged, it's not nice looking, and hard edged, and it's like it looks, feels and looks cut out. Like when you paint it on the paper, it feels like it's cut out. Okay. So it just takes a little time for you to dry. Alright, you will notice that when I wet it was very shiny. Okay. So now that it's out my I can hear myself. Alright, so while it's drying, I will prepare my wash. Different kinds of yellow, and there are many different kinds of red. So you start by take one at a time. And then when you leave, like, this is not the red I like, then you buy another one. Then you buy another one. So it's not like you have to invest a lot. Right away, but konti-konti.
Thank you.
shape.
Thank you.
that writing or something.
Yeah. Then we can work on that. Remember what I said about So with this, I can do something. more solid. I think my mom has tissue.
Precious. Okay. So paper
the best kind of treatment has to be made of cotton. Makes a cotton different. You cannot make good paintings on that paper, on the raw paper, as you say. Okay? So, for example, if you have you're going to paint watercolor on one paper, oh, forget it. You have another paper. Number one, that kind of paper, bond paper or newsprint or anything like that, is made up of wood pulp, not cotton. Cotton is fibers. Okay, so the best paper for watercolor would be cotton. Now, of course, cotton tends to be more, expensive. So some manufacturers put 50%, 100% cellulose. Use palm tree. The material that you use for regular paper is palm trees, which is called cellulose. Okay, so cellulose versus fibers. Okay, so cellulose is pulp. That's the one they make for newsprint, for book paper, or so the specialty paper for watercolor has to be cotton. So when I was first typing out, the best paper would be arches. In the Philippines, it's pronounced arches. Where it's made, it's pronounced arches. Spelled arches. But in France, where it came from, it's pronounced we're in the Philippines, so we say arches. And then recently, we've come up with also another brand is Fabriano. Okay, so Fabriano Artist Co. Okay, and then they would have 100% cotton, they would have 50% cotton. So to cater to price, to cater to the artist's need for discounts also. But always look for the manufacturer. It's the manufacturer who will be very, really used about making a good quality. So for arches, their cheaper paper is cotton. Okay, and then for Fabriano, there is another brand for them. So you always look for those distinctions. Huh? You always look for those distinctions. When in doubt, call me. Simple. I did all the research. Because in the beginning, we couldn't find the money. Okay, so I'm trying to show you another So this time I did not wet the paper, but I painted with water. Okay. I was saying here, there's no right, there's no wrong in making pairs. You know why? Because there's so many different kinds of pairs. I don't know what the shape is. It's an Asian pair, it's an Indian pair, it's an American pair. So you know this, and it's very well. Huh? And I also have a habit of an orange. Look at your red here. This is burning red. And if you want to find it, you can have your permanent rose. Okay. You can make your ultramarine with permanent rose. You have a very nice color. But then sometimes I don't want to mix, so I buy my color.
Yeah.
poison themselves. All right, so now it's getting to be
the water to the
why do I want it?